I'm the original honky-tonk train. I'm the one that you see when you're watching a western. That's me chugging by. Of the ones that you see in the fields on the Beston. I'll tell you why, cause no other local can ever compare with the places I've been, cause I've been everywhere and I never once stopped for a moment of resting. And if my fire's burning properly, the hot air ought to rise and go along a lot of tubes. But I'm surrounded by water in the boiler till eventually it moves. I'm down the engine's aorta, out to the funnel where the cloud of smoke exudes. And now the hot air in the tubes has made the water in the boiler turn to steam. Hot, hot, hot. The steam also rises and collects inside that large symbolic dome at the top, top, top. But if you think that now the steam is just as hot as it is gonna get, you're wrong, cause it's not, not, not. Because this is where the driver opens up the regulator valve handle. The steam becomes alive again and goes back through the boiler or can, which I call it only cause I've a shortage of rhymes ending in an. So having been through the superheater tubes, the steam is hotter than ever it was before. The heat is more, you may be sure. The steam now passes on into the piston cylinder and pushes the piston forwards and backwards by means of valves which reciprocate in alternation according to simple mechanical law. The piston then pushes connecting rods fixed to the wheels that are set on the rails. But that's not the end of the story, cause then all that steam, as you will have seen, is blown out as exhaust through the funnel whence it can expire, thereby increasing the draft of the fire. So now apart from some rather superfluous detail, what doubtless will seem to you obvious, hardly worth saying. The story's over in its basic essentials, the rest is merely overlaying. What you can see for yourself quite easily, although I would just like to mention the thing on the front that always comes in handy when you want to catch cows.